Hello everybody out there, and welcome back to the NNSCRA Sports and Gaming Channel, where we are about to kickstart race number 14 of Season 8 NNSCRA Walmart Cup Series. I am Levi McIntyre, aka ThrashManiac99, the voice of NNSCRA Walmart Cup Series, here to welcome you to the Eight Bowl Superspeedway, here for the Taco Bell 500. Yes, Taco Bell 500, I said it. But anyways, we're about to go 30 laps of racing here at probably the most unique plate track we go to on the schedule, since it's both left and right turns in a figure eight formation, and it should be interesting. It's been quite a while since we've been to this track, and this track has always been known for some really good racing and interesting strategy. Joining me for co-commentary, please welcome a winner already this season, Mr. Joshua Collard.
Yay, I am back. It's good to be back here.
Yep, it's been quite a while since we've had you here up in the booth.
Yeah, it's been like nearly 6 months or a year. It has been a long, long time. I miss doing this.
Yeah. So before we get started, let's take a look at the point standings as it stands currently coming into this race. Jessica Sheldon, after last week at Charlotte, took the points lead over, and she leads by 5 points over Trent Dunham. Third is rookie DJ Curtis, fourth Danny Wells, fifth Kyle Matthews. Sixth is Zachary Fitzwater, seventh Dylan Young, eighth Seth Cole, ninth Tanner Sullivan, and then 10th is Dougie Shears. The rest of the top 20 is Rue McIntyre, David Rivera, Sean Galligan, Cody Lamas, Preston Plord, Stephen Power III, Matt McIntyre, Joshua Collard, Charles Jackson, and Daniel Day. Currently, if the chase were to start right now, the top 10 would be in, as well as the two wild cards, and those would be Joshua Collard and Charles Jackson. However, you got other drivers with a victory who wants to get a second one as well. Guys like Austin LaPlante and Pichu London, who are in the top 30. Two winners outside the top 30 who really need to get some good runs going here until the chase begins, and they would be Charles Sanford and Chris Washer. And already in 13 races, 13 different winners. Could we get a 14th different winner? Or will we see somebody get a second win? Anything can happen at this track. But before we get started, let's look at the top 10 in the starting lineup. Angel Navarro on the pole. Next to him is Dylan Young. Row 2 is Zachary Fitzwater and Rue McIntyre. 5th is Zach Rogers. 6th is David Rivera. Row 4 is Trent Dunham, Danny Wells, and then row 5, Tim Walsh, and Dougie Shears. And with that said, let's get the command to fire engines at the 8 Bowl.
Drivers, stop your engines!
And there it was. And then starting in the last row will be Seth Cole and Joshua Collard. So them two are going to have to work their way up, but luckily, if you find the right line to work with in the different corners we have, you can get up there. But one of the big keys, I think, for this track is attempting crossover moves. Whenever you're going to a left-hander, then you go into a right-hander, it's going to be important to see if anybody can make crossover moves. But we shall see how this race will entail. But so, Josh, considering we're coming back to this racetrack, which is, like I said, known for its strategic passing and pit strategy even, who do you think could earn their first win this season or a second win, depending on who you look at?
I don't know. Considering this is one of my favorite tracks in all of NR, and being that I'm a two-time winner here, and from different series, of course, so one would say I have the advantage knowing this track weaving in and out of different cars, but if anything, you forget this is a restricted plate track, so I'm going to say it's going to be the drivers in the middle, I'd say the 10th row, 10th back to the 15th row. I'm going to say those drivers are the ones to keep an eye out for, because they can come out anywhere.
And the pace car pulling in the pit road, which means we're getting ready to get the green flag.
Green flag is out.
And the green flag is out. And no boogity boogity this time. I'm sorry. Yeah. But Angel Navarro gets off to a big jump on that start. About two car lengths.
Not a good idea.
And now Zachary Fitzwater in the Doritos Dodge Dart with Zach Rogers.
Love it. I love that.
And now, here comes the low line.
Yep, that's where it comes into play now. The low line works.
And look at that, it's a Ford trio right there from different teams. Two from Roush Fenway, one from Penske. Dylan Young and then the two Roush cars of Rue McIntyre, David Rivera, with Jessica Shelton giving a helping hand.
Yeah. Jesse, online restrictor play expert. And, oh, they're going to go free wide from lead, are they? Yes, they are. 28 is now to the lead.
With help from good friend David Rivera and teammate as well. Angel Navarro, who led the first lap now because he got stuck up on the high line, he's going to be slipping back a little bit, but he might gain a little bit since we're heading into a right-hander this time.
Coming into that turn one, you want to be on the inside, but then coming to this corner, you want to be on the, well, what would be considered the outside on the other turn. So this is now the inside line. So basically you're weaving left to right. Technically. Hence why this is an eight plate track.
Yeah, the figure eight plate style.
Yeah, which I love.
Yeah. And already I see the guy who started dead last, Joshua Collard's already working his way up there. Last scored in 29th.
So. I did say keep an eye out, but where's Seth Cole as well? Where's Seth?
I saw he was still a little bit of ways back. He was last scored 38th.
Well, as long as he keeps in the draft and is using those inside lines, he should be all right.
Yeah. Meanwhile, two Roush teammates in the back. Dylan Thoreau in the 99, Austin Mongold in the 16. Not really off to the best start so far right now in the race, but back up at the front, Angel Navarro takes the lead back. Hmm. And David Rivera led that lap last time by.
19 cars doing pretty well. I'm quite surprised, given these first few laps. I would have thought he'd be somewhere in the middle. No, he's still going, he's still at the front. So, there's something definitely going on in that 19.
Indeed. Dylan Young, however, right behind him, he's been hungry for a victory this season, as Dylan Young comes in this race 7th in points, not a single top 5 yet, 4 top 10s, but he's been pretty consistent, but he wants to get good, better finishes and wins to keep up his place in the top 10 in the points to make the chase. As now he's about to get freight trained by that low line coming in with Rue McIntyre, Zachary Fitzwar, Zach Rogers, Preston Plourde, among many others. But look at the guy who's in that bottom lane coming into the picture, Chris Washer. Now, Washer, he's had the biggest struggle of anybody so far this season. Currently dead last in the points despite having a win. His average finish, if I could pull it up here, 32nd. Despite one win, he has not really gotten off to a very good start, so he's going to have to get good finishes from here on out and perhaps another win and make the top 30 in points so that way he can make it as a wild card driver in the chase once again this season.
He's going to have to pull in some places and basically get that car sorted if he really wants to get that wild card spot.
Yep. And David Rivera currently now into the lead, and he hasn't won yet this season, and he fell back from 6th to 12th after getting involved in a crazy crash last week at Charlotte. In fact, Charlotte last week was quite the wreck fest, so that's going to be a race he'd love to forget about. And now here comes Daniel Day in the 12, who currently comes into this race 20th in the points. He's been starting to kind of free fall in the standings as of late. He fell from 17th to 20th after getting into a crash last week. And now Angel Navarro back up to the front. Man, he's been hanging in strong so far.
Yeah, look who's coming up behind him, that 28 again.
Yeah, it's back. Rue McIntyre coming back into the picture.
Ooh, looks like we might have a lead change coming into this turn.
Maybe, and now here comes Rivera. Rivera down low, but he needs to clear Navarro and get down to that line so that way he can keep the position off of turn 4. And Preston Plourde, look at him in the 21. Look at him go. And so far for this season, Preston Plourde, not too shabby, 15th in points. Though he fell from 11th after getting in a crash. And so far the season, like I said, not too shabby for the season 6 champion.
Ooh, ooh.
Wow, look at Cody Llamas and Stephen Pollard III now into the fray.
Yeah, five-car splitway now.
Yeah, and now we could get another lead change. Maybe not.
I don't think so.
Nope. No, Rivera just had Navarro right behind him and gave him a shot and kept him up at the front. As we continue to look in the back, and a couple of Gibbs cars running back here, DJ Curtis and Bob Jones. DJ Curtis, not the kind of day he's hoping for. Third in the points.
I don't know. It could be strategy if he's got his teammate behind him.
It could be, and they got another teammate out back here, Charles Jackson, in the 54.
I think some of the teams we saw earlier, they're just hanging in the back, just so they, especially if you've got like a high-ranking teammate who's up in the top 10, they're just going to hang back with them, save some fuel. That's what I'm looking at. That's how I'm looking at it.
And right here in this same group, five Tweenix cars. Johnny Gardner, Danny Wells, Carson Gum, Seth Cole, Dylan Poteet all bunched up back here along with Jesse Seddy and Dylan Thoreau, Dorian Facepuncher, Charles Jackson, and Austin Mongold all in this little pack.
Nothing too spectacular, nothing dramatic yet as we come across the line, complete one, is that? Yeah, we'll complete a third of this race.
Yep, and we still got pit stops to come, and depending on how many pit stops we get, should be interesting. And look at this, two fellow Dodge Darts, but for different teams. Joshua Collard for Richard Petty Motorsports, Tim Walsh for Everingham Motorsports. Oh, and I think pit stops are happening, because never mind. I thought they were going into the pits.
They go a lot lower than that, but remember that is one of the worst pit stops you could have in NR, because if you touch or make contact or basically don't get too far into the pit, off to the exit area, you could hit that barrier and those yellow flags are going to appear.
Oh, yeah.
It's happened many times. I've seen it many times. It's not a pretty sight.
Yeah, and back up at the front is Stephen Pollard III, looking for his, what I would say, is his second career win here in the series. I believe he picked up a win last season. So far, he's not really had the best of times here in season 8. He comes in 16th in the standings, and now pit stops.
Okay, keep an eye on those lights. Keep an eye on the lights. Let's have a look.
And a lot of the top cars are into the pits, and
yeah. The 28 stayed out. Ooh, some pitted early.
Yeah. Not very many stayed out. Only about a small list of them stayed out. Most of everybody went in.
Yeah, I think the Joe Gibbs teammates, they went in first.
Yeah, from
of it. Yeah. Was that one of the Joe Gibbs cars? Because, oh man, this is going to be hard now. Because you've got some of those guys getting up to speed and guys going full speed. Are they going to get out of the way for them to make a pit? We've got some of these other drivers coming out. Oof, tussling.
Yeah, they are tussling for position.
Yeah. And let's see, who are the next people to come in?
All right, it looks like Cody Llamas, Chris Washer, Michael Norman, Chris Michaels, Carson Gum, Austin LaPlante, Rue McIntyre, Zachary Fitzwater are all in. Zach Rogers. Oh, contact with Zachary Fitzwater and Zach Rogers.
And I think, where's the lead pack? Where's the 20? I reckon he...
Yeah, where is DJ Curtis?
Yeah, because I remember he...
Oh, there he is.
Oh, yeah, so would he be leader?
Let's see the scoring. Now, according to the scoring, Daniel Day is the leader.
I think he's in the pits, isn't he?
Let's see. Yeah, now he's in the pits.
Ah, okay, so he's pit. If we go back a bit, we might be able to guess where...
Yeah, there's James Silverfox.
Which would make... If I'm right...
I think Stephen Pollard III, potentially, the leader.
No, I think it's the free car? Is it?
Well, let's see here at the line if that is the case or not. According to the scoring, if they get by, it would be Michael Norman as the leader.
Ooh.
If they were to get past Daniel Day and James Silver Fox.
Whoa, where did that 19 come? Did you see him shoot out like a gun past the 48?
Yeah. All them cars we've seen up at the front all day are coming up here. And look at this. Joshua Collard in the 43 started dead last.
Again,
now up
I
in the top
you,
10.
I warned you, this guy knows the bowl. He loves this track.
And now Michael Norman in that low line going to clear the Stephen Pollard high line right now. And there's Cody Llamas, who actually know Llamas would be the leader. But he's way out ahead, but he's going to get freight trained here at any moment.
Yeah, he's going to suck it in. He's going to get that suck. He's going to get sucked in.
Sucked into a black hole and never to be seen again.
Ooh, sounds brutal.
And now Austin LaPlante now in the second, and he's looking for his second win this season. He won at the road course of Sonoma earlier this season, and now here he comes. Whoa. Oh, almost got in the Llamas.
Yeah, 15 was late on that one.
And I'm sure Llamas, he's already not happy with LaPlante taking the 48 from him. He probably ain't going to help that situation.
Oh, no, I don't think it would.
Nope. So it looks like up here we've got just only 11 car pack, or maybe less. Let's see. No, it's 9. It's actually a 9 car pack. We got LaPlante, Navarro, Llamas, Pollard, Collard, Plord, Norman, PJ Williams, David Rivera. And then it's all the way back here to Dougie Shears and then Carson Gum. And now the rest of the pack's all bunched together.
Work, yeah.
Yeah, they're only less than 6 seconds back. And we know there's going to be one more pit stop coming around between lap 22 and 23.
One of these guys is going to stretch it, I reckon. Someone in this pack might stretch it, I reckon.
Yeah. Possibly the top two. LaPlante leads that lap again, so...
Ooh.
Yeah, almost contact with Navarro and Collard. That could have been brutal.
Navarro was close. Again.
And then back here, you got James McLeod, Sean Galligan, Dylan Thoreau running way at the back. Probably just lost a draft.
Although those were... When did they were late pitters, weren't they?
I believe. Yeah, this big pack, and they're actually slowly but surely catching the top 9.
That's the 22. So... Oh, yeah. I was about to say the 21, but yeah, that's the 22.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're close. I think they're... According to the ticket, it says about 4 seconds. It's gonna come down a bit quicker than that.
Now, apparently, they lost a lot of time.
Well, that 22 there should... Well, technically he's in the middle, but I think that... I think he's 83 behind him. As long as he gets the sucker...
To Jesse Setti, yeah, indeed.
Yeah. Yeah. They're in sight. They just need to get that draft. Just need that draft to work.
And currently Austin LaPlante's still holding on to the lead. He's doing what I said drivers should do, and that's block both lanes in every corner possible.
Yeah. He's taking the middle lane, so... And then, yeah.
And now here comes PJ Williams underneath of Preston Plord for third. And PJ Williams, so far here in his first season in the 88, 31st in points. Not very good in points, but he's got top 5 and 5 top 10s to his credit this season. But aside from those good runs, he's had a lot of bad luck. Maybe that could get turned around as here he comes for second underneath Navarro.
Yeah,
so that's
gonna get it. He's going to get second.
And Navarro's going to get freight trained big time by almost everybody.
Yeah, that 22 there.
22, just saying. And then Trent Dunham and his teammate Chris Michaels.
5 seconds. 5 seconds behind. I don't know. They're all going straight now. Yeah, this is now crunch time now.
Yep, as we are a couple laps away from two-thirds of the way through. Margin from 9th on back to 10th this time. And I don't think it updated.
Yeah, it did. I think it did. 6? Yeah. Hang on, what did it
do? About a little over 5 seconds back, it looks like.
Yeah.
Back up at the front. Now here comes PJ Williams taking over the lead from teammate Austin LaPlante with Preston Blord right behind him.
I think some of those drivers are slowing down. I think they're slowing down. The one, the higher line was slowing down. So are they coming to pit, or what are they doing?
No, doesn't look like it. It was just a case of no drafting help from
I
that.
I guess might be that, yeah. And also it's a high line, so yeah.
Yeah, so. Meanwhile, in the back, and look at this five-car pack we got here. Charles Jackson, Anthony McCreary, Seth Cole, Dylan Young, Zachary Fitzwater. And I'm sure most of those guys are like, why is Fitzwater here? He's not in our group. What's he doing? And then you got Dylan Farrow, DJ Kurt, or actually, no, that's Pichu London and DJ Curtis working together right there. And then we got the main big pack who's trying to catch up to the lead pack, but it's just not working out, it seems.
Oh, it's just not doing them any good. And, they're coming in the... Oh, some of them are coming in the pit. Here we go.
Yep.
Now this is going to be bad, considering this is the big pack now. This is where it could go bad for them. The strategies could be messed up.
Indeed.
20's coming in the pit. So is the 52.
And none of the very back of the Packers are going in. So the main guys that stayed out were Williams, Plord, Rivera, Michaels, McIntyre, Wells, and Rogers, now bypassed by Poteet.
Yeah, look at this stretch.
Yep. And hopefully this will be the final pit stops for everybody. It might be close for the guys who did pit earlier, just a lap or two ago, but maybe they could stretch it out, but we'll see. It's going to be very, very close on gas for a lot of these guys.
Yeah, they all topped up. I think they just topped up just to, you know, full tank and go.
Yeah, as we are just skimming through, looking at everything, and I am surprised we have not had a caution yet, and typically we do get at least one. And it's usually an incident involving cars trying to get out of the pits and ramming into each other. It's typically how we get the cautions here at this track. Whoa! Near contact with Washer and Rogers.
They had to go high to avoid Seth Cole, man. Now, it looks like it's going to be a battle with the top two, I think.
Yep. So now that brings up the...
I think Lamas is leader. Think. Not too sure.
Yeah, currently it's scoring Chris Michaels as the leader, but now he's in pit road, along with Rue McIntyre, James Silverfox, Chris Washer, Daniel Day, Dylan Young, Zachary Fitzwater. I don't know, it could be back to PJ Williams, back to the lead, as he's all by himself.
That'll be something if PJ's leader.
Yeah, and then you got Rivera, Norman, and
Whoa,
LaPlante.
Oh my goodness.
Near contact with those guys. That could have been a major problem.
Oh, yeah.
I think I heard... Oh, the caution's out! I think there's a crash ensuing.
Where's
it? Oh, right at the... Oh, right in the front stretch. Oh, and Danny Wells. Bad luck continues for the second week in a row.
Who else was it?
Trent Dunham was involved.
Oh, man.
Trying to look around to see for anybody else.
Can't believe we jinxed it. Now everyone's...
Oh my goodness, we had a big pileup. Who was that upside down? I couldn't tell. McCreary was involved. Pichu London might have got a piece of it. Tanner Sullivan was in it. Ryan Acosta, Jesse Setti, Seth Cole, Matt McIntyre. My goodness, look at the front end of Charles Jackson. Bob Jones was in it. Oh, wait a minute, there was some more. Zach Rogers. After a good run last week at Charlotte, or actually maybe not a good run, I don't remember what happened at Charlotte much, but man, oh man, that must have been a massive, massive crash right in the front stretch going to turn one. I think that there was the car I think who got upside down. That is Kyle Matthews.
Five car.
Johnny Gardner was in it. There's Dougie Shears, Tim Walsh. There was Zach Rogers' machine. Well, we're trying to see who is the leader. According to scoring, it was Zach Rogers, but he's wrecked. So I think it's going to go to Michael Norman.
Yeah, I think it's Michael. Oh, wait, yeah. Yeah, it might be Mike. Yeah, I think it's Michael Nolan.
Yeah. But anyways, we're going to take a break, and we're going to take a look and see what brought the caution out for the first time today here at 8 Bowl. Well, guys, this might be the longest wreck analyzation we're going to ever have. Right there, it looked like Danny Wells tried to block Trent Dunham as Trent had a big run on the outside line. And this isn't where it gets exciting. Watch this. Hard hit for Danny Wells by Kyle Matthews, and then Matthews hard hit by Bob Jones, and Austin Mongold somehow got through with minimal damage.
Oh, God, Jessica Shelton gets...
Yeah, that was a close call. And then Tim Walsh, there's Gardner, Shears, Acosta. And look at Ryan Acosta when he gets hit by Zach Rogers. We're almost into the catch fence, and then everybody just starts piling in down there because of all the smoke. And all look at all those cars go upside down or on their side. Look at that. It looks like Zach Rogers on top of Seth Cole.
I think there's more.
Galligan gets involved.
Oh, and so there's the, I think that's a 20, who's that?
17 of Pichu London got in there, too.
To smoke. I couldn't see who the car was, but goodness gracious.
But yeah, we had so much happen. Let's take a look at this one more time at how it began. Yeah, there you see Danny Wells come up in front of Trent Dunham to try to block his run, and wasn't quite clear.
Yeah, not called for, by the way.
And then Wells, as he hit Dunham, it slammed him into Jessie Setti, and she's not very happy with Trent Dunham. And watch what she does to Trent Dunham. Get into him and watch what happens to Trent afterwards. Right into the pit wall. So that was like payback from the 22. But I feel like once she sees what happens, she'll understand why she got taken out. Because that was just a case of ricochet by the four. And then Bob Jones kind of was like, casually, hello, I'm sliding in with you.
What was the 22 even think of? Oh.
And there was the hit from Matthews. And then Matthews, right after that, gets a hit himself. And look at Austin Mongold. Like I said, skimmed through it. That's going to be an exciting onboard when we get to that. And then there's Walsh's hard hit from Gardner. And then watch Ryan Acosta's smashing
hit. That 20 card just gets through everyone. My God.
Yeah, DJ Curtis did a phenomenal job to get through. That's going to be another onboard we'll take a look at. But my God, man, I tell you, the guy who took the hardest hits and the wildest ride was Kyle Matthews. He took so many hard hits, so many different flips at different portions of the wreck.
Yeah, look at that. He's going to be sent to the on-site infirmary.
Yeah, and he's... can't see because of the smoke, and then right when he finally sees Wells, was right there and smashed him hard, and then Bob Jones, and man, Mongol just got a tiny buck on the hood, but not severe enough to retire him from the race. Man, this is just a massive crash, one of the craziest wrecks I think we've had all season. And then right there, that was a hard hit by Rogers into Acosta, and Acosta about went in through the catch fence. And then look at all these cars just pirouetting or going upside down, going on top of cars. Pichu London was in that, and then here comes Sean Galligan. Look at Dylan Thoreau! Oh, he gets into Charles Jackson a little bit.
Both of those cars hit at the same time.
Yeah, Jackson took a bit of a hit. And look at Mongold. Let's go to the onboard portion just for a moment. No, he doesn't have a buckle. He somehow got through that with very minimal damage. Speaking of Mongold, let's go with the onboard on 16. Onboard with Austin Mongold. This is going to be exciting. The wreck is already happening, and then watch this. Yeah. On board with DJ Curtis, and the wreck's already in progress, and watch how he gets through.
He sees the smoke, can't see anything, goes on the brakes, I think.
Starts sledding off the throttle. And right through he went. Finally on board with Kyle Matthews, and tell me, what do you do when there's smoke in front of you? And a car appears right in front of you after it's over. Tell me, what do you do?
Play pinball. You are the boy. Hit after hit. God, that was the worst. Oh, that's the worst.
Well, after that crash, we have so many cars out of the race, and they include Zach Rogers, Austin Mongold, I guess something happened, and now he's out of the race, Anthony McCrory, Jesse Setti, Trent Dunham, Bob Jones, Danny Wells, Kyle Matthews, Tim Walsh, Ryan Acosta, Dougie Shears, Johnny Gardner, Tanner Sullivan, Matt McIntyre, Charles Jackson, and Seth Cole. When we get back green, it'll be three laps to go. There's your leader, Michael Norman. Second, Austin LaPlante. Third, David Rivera. Fourth, PJ Williams. Fifth, Chris Michaels. Sixth is James Silverfox. Seventh, Chris Washer. Eighth, Rue McIntyre. Ninth, Joshua Collard. Tenth, Daniel Day. Rest of the top 20, Angel Navarro, Cody Lamas, Preston Plourd, Stephen Pollard III, Carson Gumm, Dylan Poteet, Dorian Facepuncher, Charles Sanford, Jessica Shelton, Zachary Fitzwar, and then the final cars on the lead lap, Dylan Young, DJ Curtis, Pichu London, James McLeod, and Dylan Thoreau, and Sean Galligan.
This is going to be so interesting. Considering most of those cars ahead are going to get lapped.
And also, Galligan and London may be off the pace because they were involved in that crash.
Yeah, I'm thinking that's going to be bad because this could be another jumble mess.
It could.
Here we go, free to go.
With Michael Norman looking for his first win this season. And here we go, green flag back out. Final three laps and pretty much caution out. Race will be over, pretty much.
Yeah, that's pretty much how it works. And some of those cars are up to speed.
Yeah, London's an iffy. Galligan, I think he's still running. I think both London and Galligan are up to speed somehow, some way.
Yeah. Mm. Now here we go. This is where it gets interesting. Now these, they're gonna get lapped now. Because everyone's gonna go low line. Here we go. And 99. Jesus Christ.
And now David Rivera gets into the second position. Three wide back here. Collard stuck in the middle. Washer stuck up high.
His chances of winning this race are gone.
We shall see. Anything can still happen. And two laps to go for Michael Norman. And he's got that low lane. The only guy close to him right now is Rivera, and he's going to have to stay in line and then cross over. And wow, look at the run he got. The suck up in the draft really kicked in for the six car. Now the last car on the lead lap up here is McLeod in the 51. Now he's about to go a lap down.
And whoa!
Nearly a crash up at the very front. That could have been devastating. He could have turned him, and that could have been the biggest one of them all. Yeah, and who would win, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, here we go.
Rivera's going to have to dart down low, and here he comes as the white flag is out. Here comes David Rivera, the defending champion of Season 7. Looking to get his first win this season to kick off his campaign for potentially a second straight championship.
I think he might get it.
Now Norman's slipping back. As here comes LaPlante and company. The closest one's going to be Norman. But I don't know if he's going to be able to get to him.
51 blocked him.
Yeah, the McLeod at 6 using the 51 as a pick between himself and the 3. Keep an eye on things back here. No crashes are occurring. And coming off of turn number 4 to get his first win of the season, David Rivera wins the Taco Bell 500. Here at Eight Bowl.
Oh, and look who just made it into the top 10.
Yeah, I know you. Yeah. Oh, by the way, just for old time's sake, remember that time at Thornton when you found out you fell off the turn of death and you went, "Oh, damn it!" Can you give us one of those?
Damn it!
All right, so with that said, let's take a look at the results. David Rivera, congratulations, first win of the season. That will definitely put him in the top 10 in the points again. And now all he's got to do is try to keep himself in that hunt, and he could be in the chase for a campaign for a second straight championship. Michael Norman, close but no cigar, but he's going to get a great second place run. P. PJ Williams, his second top five this season, and third, Angel Navarro, who was a car who was pretty much top five all race long, comes away fourth, and Chris Michaels gets a much-needed good run in fifth. Preston Plourd with a solid run in sixth. Dorian Facepuncher, it's been a little while since he's got a good run. He comes away seventh. James Silverfox with a great finish in eighth. Daniel Day, solid ninth. And Joshua Collard, who was probably the biggest mover of the race, started dead last, finished 10th. Solid run for him. Rest of the top 20, Chris Washer, Dylan Young, Austin LaPlante, Stephen Pollard III, Rue McIntyre, Charles Sanford, Carson Gumm, DJ Curtis, Zachary Fitzwater, Dylan Poteet. Rest of the final two cars on the lead lap were Cody Lamas and Jessica Shelton. Four cars a lap down, James McLeod, Pichu London, Sean Galligan, Dylan Thoreau. Everybody else out of the race after that massive crash. Zach Rogers, Austin Mongold, Anthony McCrory, Jesse Setti, Trent Dunham, Bob Jones, Danny Wells, Kyle Matthews, Tim Walsh, Ryan Acosta, Dougie Shears, Johnny Gardner, Tanner Sullivan, Matt McIntyre, Charles Jackson, and Seth Cole. Well, anyways, thank you, Joshua Collard, for stopping by the commentaries booth for this wacky, crazy-ass race.
Glad I did make it.
And with that said, we move on to our next race, which will be another road or another plate track as we head back to the track we went for All-Star Weekend, Coca-Cola Superspeedway, and that's going to be exciting. But anyways, here are your results, rookie points and regular points heading into Coca-Cola. And this is Levi McIntyre with my final words of wisdom. Don't be silly, kids. Wrap your willy, kids. But anyways, thank you for tuning in to the NNSCRA Sports and Gaming Channel, offline racing at its best.